Have you ever done any animation? Comment right now below. If no, this can change after this video. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and enable the bell notifications so you won't miss any future tutorials. Today, I will teach you the animation basics. Now, this episode is targeted more towards beginners, but I'm sure that even if you are a pro, you might find something useful here. Let's get started. I have a box in my scene which is not animated yet. I will show you two ways of animating. In the first one, we'll use the set key option. When you enable it, the timeline and the viewport border turn red. We can add an animation key by clicking on the plus icon. You can see it added to the timeline. Then, let's go a couple frames forward. Move the object and add another key. It's working, pretty straightforward. Let's go a couple frames forward again and move the object. If we don't add a key and move the slider, the object will go back to the previous key position. Let's add a couple more keys. Works fine, but there is a quicker way. I will select the keys and delete them. Now, let's use the auto key option. Here, we don't have to add a key each time. We only have to move the slider and the object. 3ds Max will automatically add keyframes for us. This method is way quicker and we'll use it more often. If you have to add a key, we'll use the other method. By the way, you can download my free ebook about animations in the description below. Also, I would appreciate if you can like this video, as it will help to increase its reach. Let's go back. Let me delete the keys to show you another thing. I will animate the box to move in the straight line. You can see that the speed is not constant. It moves faster, then slower, then faster again. We can control it here. Let me copy this box and animate it with constant speed. I delete the keys, change the tangent for the new keys to linear, turn auto key, move the slider to the next frame and align to x-axis. Now you can see the difference clearly. But there is now a way to control it further here. To do so, we have to enable the curve editor. Just click here to open it. First, I will show you how to move around. You can pan by clicking a wheel on your mouse. Same as in the viewport. You can zoom using this option. If you click and hold Ctrl, additionally you can zoom only vertically or horizontally. Thank you. The quicker way to zoom is to click these two buttons. It will zoom all the keys to cover the whole area. You can also zoom to a specific region if you need. Let's zoom it back to see the whole curve. Here, on the left-hand side, we can show visibility of curves. You can see all the three axes, but the Y and Z are not changing, so it's better to show only the X axis. Similar in the other box, we have to turn on the X axis. Now, you can see the difference in curves. Here, we have corner type points. And here, we have bezier points. We can control the speed by modifying the curves. I use this technique very often. Let's modify this point. Graph like this will move the box really fast at the beginning, and then it will slow down. Here is the opposite situation. In this case, it will move fast, then slow, and then fast again. And the opposite. To change the point type, we have to select points and choose the point type here. We can also add additional points and set them up. The only limit is your imagination. To delete a key, just select it and use the delete button. We can simulate almost all the options in 3ds Max and add them together. We can add a rotation, for example. Let me turn on the visibility of this graph. When we select the point, we can control the values by dragging it or by typing the new value here. We can make it spin the other way. Or make it spin faster. We can control the curve too, like we did with position. We can animate other options too, for example, modifiers. The principles are the same. After you finish setting this up, you can close the editor. All the changes will be saved. You can reopen it anytime to change something. It's not so hard, isn't it? I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and you will be able to start working on your own. Now, if you want to go to the next level and learn how to create outstanding animations, you might be interested in our animation course. Click here to check it out on our website. If you like this video, I'm sure you will love this custom playlist I created for you that has all my videos about animations. Bye-bye!